Yes, hi my people, hi everybody. Welcome to Alpha the Cipher. Yes, if you're new here, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Thank you so much. Yeah, today we are going to talk about visas, and strictly we are going to talk about a Ugandan visa. Yeah, so yesterday I got an email from a friend. He wanted to travel to Uganda and was asking me how the entire process works, and I thought it wise to do it here for any other person who would like to travel to Uganda. Why not? Uganda, the pearl of Africa, my motherland. So that's the video we are doing right now, and let's get started. Yeah, so if you want to apply for a Ugandan visa, you have two options. First, you can apply for the Ugandan visa as the Ugandan visa, only a Ugandan visa. Then the second option, you can apply for a Ugandan visa through the East African visa. The East African visa is a visa that allows you to move to 6 East African countries, so Uganda is among them. So you either choose the Ugandan visa or the East African visa. Okay? So, before we go into the entire process, I would like to take you through a review of a small clip of a story of the visa. So before 2016, the Ugandan visa was applied from the embassies in your respective country. You would go to the Ugandan embassy. That's if you have a Ugandan embassy in your country. So you would go there, fill in the forms, and pay the money and wait for the visa to come out. But as of 2016, in July, the Ugandan Ugandan government decided to introduce the e-visa. Sometimes the people call it the i-visa. Yeah. So how does it work? The e-visa is the electronic visa. This is the simplest and the easiest visa to acquire. Trust me, there is no rocket science. There is no rocket science. It only takes you just having your data or being connected to Wi-Fi, and that's it. So the e-visa can be applied from your room, from your office, from a cafe, from anywhere, as long as you're connected to the internet. So let's get started to the process. So before you apply for the Ugandan visa, you need requirements like any other documentation you're applying for. So requirements, and the first requirement, the first and the biggest requirement is a valid passport. You need a valid passport, yeah? So a valid passport should be having a minimum of 6 months, yeah? So by 6 months, I mean 6 months from the time you arrive in Uganda. Not 6 months before you travel to Uganda, but 6 months starting from the time you arrive in Uganda. And you should be the holder of the passport. It shouldn't be somebody's passport. For those people that have traveled, you know you can't use somebody's passport. You'll be caught by the immigration and you won't be allowed to travel. So that's our first requirement, is a passport. Then our second requirement, you need a passport size photo. Yeah, passport size photo, and it should be a recent passport size photo. Then after that, the second we need is, actually the third, you need to scan your information page from your passport. So the information page is a page in the passport where you have your photo, then your credentials, your name and date of birth. You need to scan that page. Then after that, you need a vaccination certificate. Yeah. So for anyone, for whoever is traveling to Uganda or leaving Uganda, it's a must for you to have a vaccination certificate and a certificate that shows that you've been vaccinated against yellow fever. For all the travelers, you must have a vaccination certificate before you apply for the visa. So for the people that travel with kids, yeah, families, any kid that is below the age of 5 years should also come with a certificate of vaccination of polio. So you should be vaccinated against polio. Yeah. So if you don't have such certificates, if you arrive in Uganda, they have a special room, a special place where they organize. When you arrive at the airport, you will be vaccinated against yellow fever and polio right away from the airport, and you will pay a certain amount. That's if you haven't done it before in your country or if you don't have those certificates. So in Uganda, you'll get vaccinated at the airport before you access the other side of the country. Yeah, so that's how it works. From there, we go to how to apply. How to apply. So there are a couple of sites on the internet, but I basically prefer the iVisa, the iVisa support service. When you open it, it will bring for you the a page where you fill in your names and credentials, fill in. After that, upload all your documentations, your passport size photo, the information page from your passport, then the certificates if you have them, scan them and upload them. Then from there, you go to the procession. So procession, how does the procession work? The visa is termed in two or three processes, okay? So the first one, we have the standard visa. Standard visa, your visa will be applied and processed within the six working days. So that's the standard visa. It's the normal visa. So we have the rush visa or rush processing visa. That visa runs for approximately 4 working days, okay? Then the last one is the super rush visa. That's for the people that are actually in a hurry or for an emergency. So it takes 2 days. So how, somebody will ask, how much does it cost? For the standard visa, it costs around $86.5. Then for the rush visa, costs around $116.5. Then the super rush costs around $151.5. So that's how the process works. So after uploading everything, the system will generate a message and will send you a message on your email on when your visa will be out. So that will be your electronic visa. So you can present it either in a soft copy or hard copy. It's up to you to print it out. And basically that's how the process works. So if you have any comments, anything, any questions, just comment. Then I'll put the iVisa description, the link in the description below. So thanks for watching, and I love you guys. Mwah.